So in this topic, we are going to restricting and sorting data. So here we will going to restrict the rows based on the my condition. Okay. So what do we mean by restricting the rows? In the previous demo, you have seen, we are going to retry each and every rows. Got it? We have choose all the columns. We already choose the specific columns, but there was no limitation on the rows. In this demo, I'm going to show you how we can keep the limitation on the rows with my clause. The limit the rows that are retried by the query. Apart from that, we are going to do the sorting the rows based on my business need. By default, Oracle will return you data in the ascending order. So whichever the row will come in the first ascending, they will return that one, and then second and third like that. But whenever we need, be it the business owner, sometimes you need to different type of rows. Return value should be like as per your condition. So that we are going to do. Apart from that, we will use the ampersand, which is the substitution. So we are going to restrict and sort output during the runtime. So maybe like example here, we can give you, suppose your business owner is asking, hey, I need a report by the manager ID. Next time he is asking, no, give me the department ID. No, give me by the highest salary. No, give me the with the employee ID. Like condition is changing. So every time, do we need to write the query again and again? No. So in this case, the substitution will help us. The filtering we can put into that condition. So these all the things we are going to learn in this module. Now let's talk about the first limiting the row. As we discuss, we are going to restrict the rows. So we are going to retrieve the data based on my condition. So for limiting the rows, we have the various conditions. The first is called, we need to put the condition, the where clause. Condition is saying that if my criteria will match, the result will be shown. If criteria is not going to match, there will be a no result. But if criteria is not matched,
your voice is not audible.
Having some issue?
No, your voice was not audible in between. Now it's okay.
Okay, no problem. So please let me know when you are facing any issue.
Okay.
So here we are going to compare the things. Then next, we have completion condition using based on my criteria. What type of completion we are going to do? So as per the my business need, be it equal to or some other. So we do like less than equal to, the between, or greater than equal to, or maybe the in operators, maybe the like operators. So different criteria ways we can filter as well. Then logical condition basis also you are going to filter, like you are able to put into the and, or maybe the or, maybe the not. So depend on that. So let's first focus on to this part. And once this is done, we will move on to the further. Got it? So later on, we will talk about the rules of precedence, then sorting, those all. So what we are going to do here? We are going to limit the rows using a selection. So if this example, you can see, I have a data, and out of this data, I need to retrieve all the employees in the department 90. I don't want this 10, 20, like maybe quite possible, your business need a certain criteria based on condition. Here I have taken the one example of department ID. Maybe the different one, you can. So based on that, you are able to retrieve all the employees into your tables. Got it? But rows which meet the my criteria. And for that, we are going to write a where clause. Where clause will be used for restricting. So limit the rows that are selected, we can use where clause. So where clause means the condition will match, then my data will be returned.
Okay.
Now, here you can see in this example, I am putting select employee ID, last name, job ID, department ID from employees. So I will get only those employees who will meet the criteria of department ID 90. Yes, so this is my criteria. What happened? How my query will process? Of course, query will going to fire from the employee table. They will get all the rows and then they will look the condition. So they will start the things called department ID is equal to 90. So they are going to filter out. The criteria will match. That will be there. The criteria is not there. That will be removed.
Okay. Yes, so I mean,
please let me know once you are able to see my screen.
I can see.
So I am setting the environment variable like dot ora environment, and my database name is ORCL. Okay, and I'm logging into my database. So for that, I am going to use SQL Plus. So this virtual machine was shut down. Let me start it. My database, I am going to start. Okay, and now here I am connecting to my HR user where my schema is kept. Got it? And once my SR user is connected, I am able to run my query. Got it? I am able to run my query, which we have seen in our presentation. So let me write the query. Of course, we have already written in the notepad, so I'm just putting into paste to save my time. Now here you can see. The same query which we were writing earlier, we were getting all the rows. Let me execute my previous query, which will give you the idea. The query is the same, only I put a condition. Here what I did, where department ID equal to 90. Got it? So only I got the rows, which is matching the criteria called this 90. Got my point? So any rows yes. Which belong to the department 90, only those are coming. And if I will write a query like this, I will get all the rows. Got it? Be it anything. That means if condition we are not putting, we are getting each and every rows. But when I put a condition, I get the rows which is matching the my criteria. So it is based on the my criteria only, I am getting the rows. Like here you can see. I hope you got the answer.
Yes, yes.
So similar way, we are able to write the different queries for different purposes. But my point, and you are able to run it as per your business need. Next, character string and dates. So as we have communicated in the previous, the character and date are case sensitive. How? The character is the case sensitive and date is a format sensitive. So when you are comparing your data with the character, like I want to check with the name called last name equal to Valen, or the hair date is equal to so and so, In this case, if I will not put a single code, CAPS have the different ASCII code. We already discussed in the previous session.
Yes. Then
date is the format sensitive. So they will not going to match it as it is. Are you getting my point?
Yes.
So to avoid those conditions, we always follow the things called we can put into the character and date with the format. So put in the single code. So character, string, and date values are enclosed with single quotation mark. Character values are case sensitive, whether date value are format sensitive. Now the one question will come into my mind. Generally we know DD, MO, and RR. So here, what is the meaning of the RR? Do you have any idea?
That is ER, right?
Yeah, it's ER, but how? RR. So basically, Oracle have a different type of storing format of the ER. They store only the last two digit. Got it?
Okay.
They put like 0 to 49 and 51 to 100, or you can say 99. 0 to 50 or 51 to 100. Instead of 49, we can write like 50. Okay. Now, what it means? So this we will cover into the another topic, RR format. What RR format is saying, if a specified result, that means which year I am choosing, those are greater than 50 and the required is also greater than 50, they will return you the current century. If those are less than the 50, then it will go into the previous century. So we will talk it in the detail. Got it? But as of now, just you understood, we store year only in the two digit internally. Oracle store year in a two digit. Be it you are inserting 1996 or you are storing 2020. Got it? Whichever you are storing, Oracle will store only last two digit. But my point.
Okay.
Now, how we know, is it for 1996 or is it for 20th century or 19th century? Got it. So that's why Oracle store years into the previous century. That means the past century, current century, and the future century. So like that. That is called the RR format. There is nothing like full form name, so I can give you. Got it? So don't be confused.
Yes.
Now, if I am going to
run this query,
yeah, you were saying something.
No, I said got it, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, welcome. Now I am going to run the same query and let's see how the result will return. So I'm writing the same query here to save my time. As I said, so here what happened? I have a valen. But if I will write the same query, let me write the same query here. And then we can see the result. From implies, okay. And then we are putting where last name is equal to I'm not putting here single quote. Can I get a result?
Yes, you will get the result, but it
let me try.
It will not. Yes,
I will not get the result.
No.
Because whenever they found a character, they are thinking this is the identifier and you need to pass in a single quote. Okay, let me try with another way.
Okay.
Let me try with another way. Same query. From implies, I am putting. And then I'm putting where last name. And here I'm putting in the small. I cannot get again. Same. So it doesn't mean you are putting in capital or small. It depends on the your single quote. So single quote is saying the specific character is my character type, and that's why you have to return the data in a character format. Got idea?
Yes.
Okay, now tell me one thing. If I will put in a single quote with the small, am I get a result?
Yes, you will get the result.
How?
Because you're putting the strings, right? And it will look only for that particular word or the character. You're specifying that particular word or the character.
Just I'm copying because my keyboard is not working, as I told you.
Yeah.
So I put here single quote and then I am putting in a small. Will it give them any result?
Yes, it will give. It should give.
No, it won't. See, in which condition it will give? If there is a last name which start with a small character, well, and in the small character, if it is there, they will give. So this data is safe. So this time you will not get the error. Let me try. So error is not there. Are you getting my point?
Yes.
So this time the result you are getting, no row selected. It shows that your table have the data, but they are not matching with the this. That's why you are not getting the rows. So your query is correct.
Okay.
Your query is correct, but data is not matched as per your condition, and that's why you are not getting the result. Clear? But in this case, sir, I was getting the error. That means my query is not correct. Whenever you will get the error, like ORA hyphen, so many numbers. Got it? That means there is a problem in my syntax. I have to check the syntax. Got it?
Got it, sir. Got it.
Good. Now, the next query, let me one query which we have seen. For the date, I can use for the date as well. As the I told you, date is a format sensitive. Whether this is the my character sensitive, of course.
Yes.
Don't forget your SQL syntax is not case sensitive, but your data is case sensitive. So here I am putting the date. No, you didn't get because it is a break. Got it? Let me put a select last name from implies. And then we put here, okay, let me go for the my notepad and then I change it. So I am putting something here as per the my convenience. The date format I am changing as per the computer understanding.
Okay.
So Now if you can see, I'm getting the my rows, but if you can see here, date. Now I put the date format, as I said, date, DD, MON, which is called month, and RR. Will I get the data? No. Why? Because we have given couple of more space there. Got it?
Yes, yes.
So when you are putting in a single quote, that means exact matching is required. What we are expecting this time, they will result. They will give you result. Yes. Yes. If data is there, matching criteria, they will give. So if I will fire, select last name, as it is, I am firing, select last name, and then I am putting here high date. And then we'll try to get it. Okay. Now, if I can put this data, just example, I'm taking this data. So we are expecting result. Am I correct? Or we are putting the 7 June because we have a multiple data. Am I correct?
Yes.
So let me put that data. We know in my table, I have this data. So I have many data over there in my table with this one.
Yes.
Can I get data now?
Yes.
I will write a query like this. Will I get the data? Yes. Now you are getting the data. So what happened? This shows it is a complete a format sensitive. If exactly it will match, then only result will be shown. What I did, I just copied yes. this data, or according to your format, these four row were matching, and that's why you are getting those four rows. Got my point?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Any doubt, any question so far?
No.
So no, sir. That's about the state format. Now, whatever you are doing with the mathematics, similar thing you are able to do with the SQL. So all the operators which is working in mathematics, they will work like equal to, greater than equal to, less than equal to. Here you can remember not equal to symbol is not greater than, not less than means not equal to. Between. What is the meaning of between? Suppose I am writing 50 and 80, between means. In this case, 50 will be also counted and 80 will be also counted. Got it?
Why, sir? Because we are writing in, right?
Yeah, between means this starting number from where we are starting to the ending number, both will be inclusive.
Okay.
In the like case, suppose I am putting 40, 50, and then 80. Just example. Will 60 come?
Yes.
No. So in case they will not return. In case they will match only the value either 40, 50 or 80. Got it? If we have put it in a between condition, then 60 will be also considered. 61, 62, 67, whichever is coming between 50 to 80, those all will be considered.
Yes. But
when we are putting in the in, that means only a specific data which in my set. Got it? That will match. Another one is called like. Like means sometimes you need to retry the data which is starting with the A, or maybe you need a name which start with the D, or whatever the condition. Or you want to second character A, Got it? So underscore will denote to the one character. If third character you want to A, then you can give the two underscore and then A. In that case, like operator will be used. Got it? So like operator is used for that purpose.
Yes.
And then we have a is null. Is null value means when the data is not there, that case. So let me show you the example of these couple of data completion. So I am putting completion operator less than equal to. So just give me the answer. Will 3000 come or not?
So sir, it will be fetching the data where the salary will be equal to 3000. Either it is 3000 or which is near closer to 3000.
Yeah, that is the question to you. I asked the same question. Will 3000 come or not?
It will come.
Why it will come?
Because it understand is the condition. Less than.
Understand the condition. What I mentioned? Less than equal to.
So no. Then 3000 will not come.
Got it.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, so you know it's less than and equal to, so 3000 will not come.
Okay, that is your answer. If I say this is wrong, then you will ask me to execute it. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So let me execute this query and then see the result. Of course, 3000 is not less than 3000, but it is equal to. Got it? 3000 is,
yes, sir,
not less than 3000, but it is equal to. Am I correct? So
yes, sir.
It should come. 3000 should also come. Let me check on the machine. Yes, if you can notice here, as I say, 3000 is coming.
Yes.
Got it, because 3000 is not less than 3000, but is it equal to or not? Can I write like
to, because you've given the
less than equal to,
I have put it. Less than or equal to, yes.
Yeah, so less than it is not, but equal to it is.
Yes.
Got a point?
Yes.
Okay, good. Now the another query which we have used. Let me show you between. I told you the between, am I correct?
Yes.
So in between condition, what will happen? This 2500 will also come and 3500 will also come. Here you can see the example. 2500 and 3500, both are coming. Am I correct?
Yes.
Let me execute it and see, is it coming or not?
Sir, 3000 is coming now.
Yeah, it is showing on my slide, but will it come in actual or not? Maybe.
It will come, sir.
It will come. Yes. So here you can see, this is coming. Am I correct?
Yes,
2500 is coming. Similar way, 3500 will also come. Getting my point?
So if I've got you right, when you're putting the condition between, now for example, select from employees, okay, select last name, or this query, right? Select last under comma salary from employees, where salary you're giving between the range of 2000 and 2500. So it will include 2000 and as well as 2500 and the numbers that are coming in between, right?
Yes. So be it 2501 or between 3499, those all will come. Okay. Now in,
yes,
as
sir.
I said, in only those come either 100, 101 or 201, but will 111 will come? No, that should not. As I said, in operator will do what? It only return the data which is in the range. Range means which I have passed in the in clause.
It is specific to that number that is mentioned.
Yeah. So let me show you that one. How will it come or not? So here I have passed 100, 101, and 201. If you can see the data only, I am getting either 100, 101, and 201. Not 104, not 105. Whichever will come between, nothing will come. That is the in operator. After that, I told you the like operator.
Yes. Yes, it will match the exact.
Exact, yes. So let me show you the like operator. I want the name start with the S. Select first name from implies where first name like S capital. So after that, how many character, I don't care. But my point, after that, how many character, I don't care. I need only data which is there. Got it? Similar way, I need to data which is starting with the R. Got it? So I am getting it. If you can see here, third character is the, okay, fourth character you can find S. Got it? Or maybe second character E. I want only those implies whose second character is E. What I told you, underscore, am I correct? Well, let me show you that one. I will get data only here in this example. What I did, I have just put the second character. So underscore is the first character. Second character, I want those name whose second character is E. So all the name which is returned having the second character E. Similar way, I want the third character different. So similar way, two underscore I have to give.
Yes, okay. Four characters, three underscore I have to give.
Yes, whichever the position. Now the question will come into your mind.
Yes.
Hey Rajiv, where it will be used? Maybe you are going for the lottery system or something like that. In this case, you can get the such type of data. Here you can see I put a two underscore. The third character I want from the name, which is come the N. So I know here the Dane is there. I am expecting that should be returned. If any other name with the third position N, that will also come. Oh, so there is a many. You can see. Any name which is returned, third character is N. Getting my point?
Yes, yes.
So this is called the in operator. Sorry, in we talk the like operator. And if we will put here in the search percentage, so percentage denote to zero or many characters. So if anywhere I will put the percent, that means after that, how many characters is there, I don't care. Maybe the one, it will come. Like percent D I put. So whichever the name is starting with the D, and it have only D, not any other character, that will also come. Or suppose there is a Dheeraj, that will also come. Dinesh, that will also come. Divakar, that will also come.
Yes.
Dhruv, that will also come. Dennis, that will also come. So which will like that, percent D. So the that means the character which is starting with the D, that I need. Got it?
Yes.
Here we have seen that second O, we have Null means where the null operator you are going to use. So only one of the employee we have, the top employee who don't have any manager, like super boss. We are reporting to some manager. Am I correct? You are also reporting to someone. Yes. His employee ID is your manager ID. My boss employee ID is my manager ID. But the company owner, do they have the any manager ID? No, they are not reporting to anyone else. So such type of thing we are able to do. Okay, there is only one employee who don't have manager ID. That is the boss, King. I am expecting the result. You got the same King result.
Yes.
Getting the point?
Yes, sir.
Now, same way, we can do with some other things like and, or, not. And what will do? It will return true if the both condition is are true. Whenever you are meeting and, like where salary is greater than 5,000 and designation is manager. So both the people who have the manager ID.
So it will have where the it will reserve, it will display 5,000, those who are having 5,000 as well as those who are manager.
But suppose they have the 8,000, but they don't have the manager. Will it return?
No. Both the conditions has
both
to be
the conditions
same.
Should be true, then only it will return. Or means yes. Anyone. Same query if I will use
either
the
one. I mean, for example, yeah, if you're saying select last name from employees where select last name from employees or select name where name is equal to Ram or Sham, so it will display anyone if that's listed, right?
Correct. So that's like here, okay. You can see I have used here and condition, got it. So I need those employee who is manager. Percent I denotes be the yes. Any manager. Percent, as I told you, it denotes to the one or many characters. So earlier, what is that? I don't care. After that, what is that? I don't care. If any character they will found in job ID, MAN, together they will return. Got it?
Yeah.
And the second condition, they also match. The salary should be greater than or equal to 10,000. Similar way I put with the or. Now you can see he is also coming. He is not manager, but the salary is matching. Am I correct? Like here, he is advertisement president. His salary is matching with the criteria of 24,000, which is the greater than 10,000. But this is not matching. Okay, this is not matching. He is not manager. But still he is coming. So that is the difference between the
yes.
Or and and. Similar way, not in means except these all should be returned. Not in means I don't want which is pass in the not in value. Like in, I want only that is pass in the in. Before in, just put a not. So not in will do. It will not find these rest all. So let me show you the demo.
It will
of
exclude.
Yeah,
it will exclude these three and
yes,
display the remaining things.
Yes, correct. So let me show you all these three demo, which I have shared. So that will give you the idea how and will work, or will work. Of course, query is the same. So there is no difference in the query. To save my time, I don't want to type the query. Otherwise, it will take a longer time. Got it? How many rows? 7 rows you got.
Yes.
But same, if we will match with the or, we are expecting the more row because the criteria will match. One of the criteria need to be match or condition.
Yes.
So I am expecting the more result. Just a simple mathematics formula. Yes, I am getting 24 rows. Got it? My query is the same. Just I put the, instead of and, I put or. If you can see in the, my previous query, what I did? I have just put the and condition. Like here,
yes,
I put the or, and earlier I put the and. So instead of and, this time I put the or, and I got the more result. Because one of the criteria match, like here you can see, it's a representative, so it's not a manager, but salary match with the another condition.
Yes.
Out of two, any one condition will match, you will get the result.
So if I've got it right, in and condition, both the values should satisfy, both the values should be true.
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
Correct.
If I'm asking, you know, I need to get a result, you know, Ram and Sham. So both Ram and Sham needs to be present. If anyone is present, I won't get the result.
Yes.
In or, if I'm giving the condition as Ram or Sham, so if Ram is there, then I'll get the result. Okay. And in not in, when you say not in that, what will happen? Out of the tables, whatever the data are there table. Okay, now for example, here it's partner, Tucker, King, Vishni and all. Now if I put into bracket, I don't want, you know, I want the data excluding Tucker, King, Vishni. Then I'll put not in into bracket and then Tucker, comma, Vishni, comma, slot key. So it will exclude these three person name and the remaining data will be displayed.
Yeah, correct.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Good. So that's why we got the many rows when we put the in condition. So in condition, what happened? Except these three, not IT programmer, not the clerk, not the sales representative, rest all I want.
Yes.
Got it?
Yes.
Like sometimes you want, okay, except the programmer, how many employee in our company? Or maybe except the manager, how many? That these are the cases where it will match. Or except the clerk and programmer, except the manager and above, like that. Got it? So in those criteria, yes, it will match. Now, let's talk about the other pillar which we discussed before the session. So this we did with the limiting rows. Now we are talking about rules of precedence. Of course, simple mathematics formula will apply as we discuss first arithmetic operation, then concatenation operator. Concatenation means we are just going to add it, concate. Like yesterday we have seen with the pipe. Similar way, concate is the word which we can use. Comparison conditions, then is not, null, like not in, then not between, then not equal to, not logical, and logical, and or logical. Of course, we can override this rule with the parenthesis, because we know in mathematics, first parenthesis will be one. So same rule of precedence will apply in SQL as well. Like in this example, you are saying, I put the or and. Got it? So here you can see, first it will apply and, then it will apply or. Am I correct? When we put and or together, so first it will apply and, after that it will go with the or.
Yes, sir.
And that is applied in the example here you can see. So, what it is saying, whoever is a president that must have the salary greater than 15,000, then only it will come. But in the case of this, it applied the or sales representative. So one criteria match, it is not more than 15,000, but still it is coming. Why? Because they fall in the or category.
Yes.
Similar way, here I put the parenthesis. Now, the both will apply together. Got the idea? Rules of precedence?
Yes.
Do I need to execute it?
No, that's okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay. So you have to do the practice for those all there. Okay. Next one, sorting rows using the order by clause. So we can do with the like ascending, descending. Similar way, we can sort based on the column, based on the things. Like I want the sorting on the basis of the hire date. So sort the retrieve rows with the order by clause. So be it ascending, be it descending, you can. Got it. So order by clause comes last in select statement, and you are able to do it order by hire date. So I can able to get the order by hire date. Okay.
Yes.
Next one, sorting. Sorting in descending order, that means just a reverse. Means hire date, who is the new joinee? That will come first and then it will come to the later. So let me show these one, two example that will give you the more idea how we can proceed further. Not taking the much time, I'm just showing you the what we covered till yet. So first I will show you the one example of AND or an AND together. What I described over there. So both is coming. As per my criteria, you can see here what I guided you. If anyone having the precedent, they must have the salary greater than 15,000. But it not apply to the sales representative because they are conditional match with the OR. That's one.
Okay.
Next was same query and we put with the OR. So if you remember, we got only one row. Or whoever, that means the that applied accordingly as per the my business logic. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
So wherever you can put, if I can put a parenthesis, then condition will change. The same query, but now I am putting in the parenthesis. And let me see what result I am getting. Got it? I did here. And I put the job ID and then precedence. Let me give the where condition I put job ID and advertisement precedent. I just put the column there. So we put the parenthesis and then we see. Here you can see in the my query, I just change it with the parenthesis. Now criteria will change. Got it? That means be it sales representative, be it advertisement president, I don't care. Salary should be greater than this. So or applied onto that case. Parenthesis first and then end applied. That's right.
Yes.
Next one, I was talking about the sorting. So order by clause, as I told you, I can get the data based on the my order clause. By default in ascending order, so higher date I will get according to the ascending order. Of course, first 7, then 8, Jan, Feb, March, like that, ascending order. Similarly, if I will put in the descending order, just a reverse. If you remember, describe, we did into the before the table name describe, it will show you the structure. But after column name, it is putting in the descending order sorting. Like here. Now you can see 2001 is coming last.
Yes.
Got it. So it's just in reverse order, descending order. That we did for the sorting. Similar way, we are able to do with the column basis. I want the filtering onto the column basis. Got it. So let me show you Here what I am doing, select last name, job ID, department ID, hire date from employees, order by 3. So here you can see department ID is filtered. Am I getting 80, 90, 100, 110? I have not put a column name. Instead of column name, I put a 3. That means first column, this is my first column, this is second column, and this is my third column. So I filtered basis onto my this column. If I will put here, instead of 3, I will put 4, it will go onto the hire date basis. Got it?
Okay.
It is not mandatory. Yes, yes. We have to do with the column name only. We are able to sorting based on the column as well. Am I able to do sorting with the multiple column? Yes, we can. But when we are doing with the multiple column, that time always we have to keep first, it will go into here. You can see the multiple column I am filtering order by 2 column. I put department ID and salary. So department ID is okay. I have not put anything, so it will come in the ascending order. Suppose the another I put like here salary, and salary case what I did in descending order. So suppose there's a 2 employee A and employee B. So according to department ID, both are working in the department ID 10, just example. So which will come first? Of course, A should be first.
Got no, it? B will come, sir, because you asked for descending, right? So B will come first.
No. I descending onto basis of salary, not onto department ID.
Okay.
So now he is getting the 1000, just example, 1K, okay? And he is getting 5K.
So A will come first only?
No, B should come first, na? Descending.
No, sir, B will come first.
How?
Hello?
Yes, how?
B will come first, yeah, descending, ulta, yes, sir.
Yeah,
so because 5000, na sir.
So let's see the result. That's why I put a query. Got it? So in this query, let's see the result. Here you can see they all are working with 100 department. Am I correct?
Yes.
Now, if you can remember here, 100 department. What name you are getting? Greenberg. What is my query? Yes. Filtered on the basis of department ID. So department ID 100 they did. Later on salary in descending. So he is getting the more salary.
Yes.
So you can see the condition change. His return. Similar it applied into this name. In department 110. Got it. And the same way, that's in my previous example, which I draw, the B should be returned first. Because, of course, department ID wise, both are the same, equivalent. Both were working A and B in department 10. But when we talk about the salary, B was getting more salary. And as per descending order, B should be more value, it should be returned first.
Yes.
If I have not put the descending over there, then A should be there.
Yes, sir.
Got it?
Yes, sir.
Now, let me show the another things. So, this is the example of sorting. Now, some situation variable. As I told you, maybe your manager is asking the result with a different ways. That time this condition will match. Sub-situation variable will always help you when you are not fixed with the particular column. Maybe during the runtime your condition may change. That time how many query we have to write. To avoid those, people can use sub-situation variable. Of course, Like here you can see, the manager is saying, hey, I need a filtering with the salary basis. Later on, he is saying, no, I don't want on the salary basis. Instead of, I want on department ID wise. Later on, they are saying, oh, no, I want a last name wise. So do we write the 20 or 30 query based on the condition? This is just few examples. No. In this case, the substitution variable will help. How to write that? Simple logic is that ampersand we have to put. Got it? So let me go and see the result. Substitution variable. So there's a two type of. If you want to store temporary value, like temporary value means every run they will ask you the value. This is called temporary value. Whenever you will execute a query, they will ask you the value. Got it? That is called temporary. And if you want to put the value permanent, so that will be double ampersand. Permanent means what? During the particular session. Once you exit from session, again you run the query, they will again ask you the input. Just all you know, substitution variable can be used with the where clause, order by clause, column expression, with the table name also, like sometimes they want different table should be added, or entire select statement also you can do. But I never found anyone is using for entire select. So let's see the couple of example here. Of course, this output which you are seeing in the screen, if you are running with the SQL developer, then this type of box will come. They will ask you input. Otherwise, your cursor will ask with the some value. I will show you into that. Single ampersand, and then same time, it will, whenever you will run, it will give you the value. They will ask you input, that means imply number, and accordingly, they will give you the data. Like here, number is given. Next time, job title given. Got it? But even if the column name it shows, where condition it shows, order by column it shows. Got it? Those are. But double ampersand means this will be fixed. Next query when you execute, it will not ask the column name. So that time we use double ampersand. So, and the last but not least, define and verify. So define is a similar like a double ampersand. Once you define it, it will be available until unless you are not undefine it. So it's just like a variable. So you have defined it, implied number, and then you are putting the single ampersand. So they will not ask you the number, instead of it will take the value from the your variable. That is the define. Use the define command to create and assign value a variable, and use the undefined command to remove a variable. Set verify on. What it will do? The verify means it will give you the old value. Okay, what is used previous query. When you have executed last time, what was the value that will call with the set verify on. Got it? Similar way. Okay. So the question to you. Which of the following are valid operation for the where clause?
Which of the following are valid operators for where clause?
Yes.
Where greater than or equal to first one, sir?
I don't know answer. That's why I asked you.
Yes, sir. That it is not. That is, yeah, first one here, then you have is null.
So then we can use
is equal to
where clause we can use with the this or not.
We can use.
Okay, so that's the correct answer.
Where salary is greater than, yes, or equal to.
Yeah. Similar way, right, can we answer. Use with the is null or not?
We can use it.
Okay. Then my question to you, am I able to use with the this not equal to? No, na.
Well, not equal.
Not
line.
equal
we
to we are writing like. Not equal to we are writing like this. Am I correct?
Yes, yes, yes.
So that's why it's a incorrect. Third one is not correct. Am I able to use with a is like?
Salary is like. Yes.
No. We use like, not is like. There is nothing called is like. We have a like operator, not a is like operator. Okay. Have you heard is
yes,
like
yes.
operator?
No.
Am I able to use in between?
In between, ha, sir, na?
How?
Yes.
How?
Salary is in between 2,000 and 5,000. Hello?
Yes.
Sir, that is right.
Okay.
Then
so,
in...
one is correct. Two is correct. Three also not equal to, we can write like this way. If you are using Deskwell developer and other things, it will work. There's a nothing like is like. We have a like operator. There's a nothing like in between. We have a in or we have a between. Both are a different operator. So this is not correct.
Yes, yes.
And not equal to yes. So the answer is 1, 2, 3 and six. Got it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now let me show you that in the demo. We were into the previous example. Are you able to see my lab machine?
Yes.
So let me run the first query, substitution variable. Query is the same, just I'm putting here substitution. Got it? So it will ask me the employee ID. Any employee ID I can put and I can get the data. Am I correct?
Yes.
Let me run it. Suppose the box I told you in the theory, remember? So box is not there. I can write like 101 employee ID. Next time again I query executing. Slash means I'm executing the query again. It will again ask you the employee number. This time I am giving 102. Again, I am executing this 103. Getting my point? So single ampersand means, as I told,
yes.
Whenever you will execute, it will ask you the input. Okay.
Yeah, and if you put double ampersand, then it won't ask for again.
Yeah, before coming to the double ampersand, let me go. This is for the number value. What about a character case? Will it work? Yeah, it is working. So let me give the my IT programmer. I'm getting all IT programmer. Am I correct? Then another was SAREP. Have you remember?
Yes.
Sales representative. I'm getting. Got a point? Similar way, what happened with the double ampersand? Before coming to the double ampersand, as I told, we can use with the column name, we can able to use with the where clause, we can able to use with the order by clause. So let me show you the one example of that. Select employee ID, last name, but here fourth, first, second, third column I have given, fourth column I have not given. Got it, column name. From implies where condition by order by. So here Second, I have mentioned here on the basis of condition. And third, on to filtering, order by. So we can use on the column name, we can use on to condition basis as well as an order by clause. Can I execute it? Okay. So first it asks about me. The fourth column, what I want. So I want the fourth column should be salary. Okay. Then it is asking me the condition. What condition I am putting? Salary greater than 15,000. Salary greater than 15,000. Okay. And third is it is asking me order by column. So order by I am putting like last name wise. Yes, I got the data. That means simple answer is that substitution variable you are able to use with the column name, you are able to use with the condition as well as with the filter shorting as well. So these are the example for the single ampersand. Now let me show you the double ampersand. So what I told you, double ampersand will ask only first time. So here I put on the same query, I just put a column name double ampersand. But condition, I put the only one. So can I execute it? It asks for the column name. What I should give? Okay, let me give the department ID. This is my condition. I got the data. Am I executed next time? It is not asking. You can see it is not asking. I am running the query same.
Yes.
It is not asking me the input. So that is the difference between the single ampersand and double ampersand.
Okay.
But if I will exit from the session, as I told you, and again I can connect with the session, will double ampersand work?
No, you have to start it again. You have to give it again.
Yeah, so let me, my query I have already copied. Let me run the query. No, it is asking me. Got it?
Yes.
And next time, again, I can run without the that. That's the difference between the single ampersand and double ampersand.
Yeah, single ampersand is a temporary one and double ampersand is a permanent one.
Yes.
However, when you exit
maybe you have a question, then why to use the double ampersand? Of course, couple of places people can use this, that one as well. Like when they want to okay, particular session, like you are working for finance department. You know the department ID is equal to finance. And you are working with the R&D, HR, account, like that. Those people can use like that type of query. Okay. After that, we have seen the another one called define. Have you remember? Again, define will work like the same way. Here you can see I am putting the employee number 200. So there is a one variable I define, which is called employee number. And what value I pass to this variable?
200.
Okay. Now, whenever I will run the query, employee number, let me check and run this query. It's not asking me the value. Where I have used the single ampersand. Have you got? I have used the single ampersand, but they have not asked me the value. Why? Because the variable is already passing the value. If I will execute second time, again, it will work like the same way. So it should work like a double ampersand. Got it? But if I will undefine the employee number, and then it will again ask me the same thing. This time it will ask me the value. I put the undefined number, so then it is asking me employee number. This time I put 100. Again I execute. This time again it is asking me the another one. So I hope you understand the define, undefined, single ampersand, double ampersand.
Yes, sir.
Last but not least, verify on. So verify on is a one type of toggle. So what do you mean by this toggle? It will ask you during the runtime the value should be pass. So I put the verify on. So my set verify is on, and now whatever the value I am passing. So let me execute the query. What data I am getting? Let's see. It asked me the employee number. No problem, I got the employee number. So suppose I am passing the value for 200. I got the data for 200. But next time I execute it, again it asks. Got it. So there's no difference like the single ampersand or double ampersand, but it is a value which it is passing. So it is showing me the variable value old one. So old one is the variable, and then new value what I am passing. That's it. So verify on means the message toggle is just on. I hope you got the answer of your queries.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Yes, sir.
So now can you give me the answer of your the same question which I asked, because I have shown you all the demo?
Yes, the first one is right.
Okay.
Then third one is also right. Second one is also right.
Okay.
And the sixth one is right.
Good. Why I ask this question? If you are going for international exam, such type of question will ask in your exam.
Okay.
Apart from that, it will give you the idea ki, okay, as a lead, I cannot use is like operator. There's nothing like is like operator. There is nothing like in between operator. Of course, we have a like operator. We have a between operator.
Between.
We have a separate in operator. Got it?
Yes.
So that's for the this topic. Of course, we did a where clause to restrict the rows. We have used the completion condition. We tried with the between, in, like, null operator. We have done with the logical also, and or not. We did the order by clause. We did the substitution variable like single ampersand, double ampersand, verify. Define those all. Any doubt, any question?
No, sir.
Okay. So in the practice, you need to select the data and changing the order of the rows that are displayed. Then restricting rows by using the where clause, sorting the rows using by order by clause, and using substitution variable to add flexible to your SQL select statement, which I have shown you a few minutes. Got my point?
Yes. Yes, sir.
So I hope it is clear to you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, if I can run the same as per my query which I asked, so let me show you the select statement. The question to you, will this selectment statement will execute or not?
Then select last and job ID, salary as sal from employees. Sir, wo rehna chahiye na sir, semicolon.
Where? I don't
sir, from want... employees ke baad semicolon.
It is there.
Sir, it will run.
It will run. So true or false, you have to give the answer. Yeah, it's run. It's a true. Got it? Next question to you. Will this query run or not?
Select star from job grids. It will also run, sir.
Yeah, so it is also true.
Yes.
Then what happened?
No, it's
So the column is not available. Job grades table is not available. Object. Of course, query is correct, but if data is correct, yes, it doesn't mean
yes, sir, table name object is not there. It will not give table. Yes. Select star from job grades where from table.
No. We don't have table with the name of job grades.
Hello.
Yeah. We don't have object with the name of job grades. That's why we don't get.
Yes.
Okay. Give me the. In this query, which are the problem you found? I'm not executing the query. Give me the answer.
Last name salary into two. Sir, that salary into two into annual salary, sir.
That is the one problem. Okay. What is the another problem?
Yes.
There is a fourth problem. Mm-hmm. According to me, there is a fourth problem.
Select employee ID, last name. Sir, from should come, from employee should come between, na sir?
Huh?
Comma nahi hai na sir, uske baad.
Not required. Last column, we don't need a column. Of course, after last name, we need. After last name, we need.
What I'm saying.
Comma, in the first line, last name we need. Second, salary into 12, we cannot write like that.
Yes.
Annual salary.
It should be.
Yes. We have to write in
a bracket mein board mas.
Yes. Like that. Okay.
Yes.
So you are getting the point. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Good to know that. So employee table does not contain the column salary. That is the first problem we have, right?
Yes.
Cell, we have a column named salary. Okay, yes. That is the first problem. Then multiplication operator, we cannot use the x. Instead of that, we have to use a star. That's yes. The second problem in second line.
Yes.
Then you can see annual salary allies cannot be include a space. We have shown you in the previous session.
Yes.
Allies should read annual underscore salary.
Yes.
And within the double quotation mark. Apart from that,
yes, sir.
As we discussed, a comma is missing after the last name.
Yes.
So that is the problem onto that query. Got it?
Yes, sir.
If you remember yesterday, we talked about a couple of operator, concat.
So yes.
We are able to write a query like concat operator. Here you can see. So many concat I have used. What? Select employee ID. Then I have added between that space, first name, then added last name, like that. Got it?
Yes.
So here you can see data. So multiple column I have added. Okay. Concat can be used for the n number of columns, depending on your business need.
Yes.
Got it?
Yes, sir.
So that's for this demo. I hope you understood the things.
Yes, sir.
Good to know.
Sir, what?